Hey, good morning, everyone. Today is the 26th of June. It's day 65 for me. So we stayed in the Tuxedo Motel last night. It is a few miles off the trail. I ended up doing about 23 miles yesterday. There's a couple different roads that you actually can take to get to the Tuxedo, so three to be exact. And the one that is called out in AWOL's guide, which is 17, was probably about 5 miles on the road, and I just wasn't in the mood to do the extra miles. I wanted to get to the hotel, motel, a little early. So I got off on West Mombasa, and there was a guy I met on the trail yesterday that was doing a day hike, and talked with him a little bit, and he offered to come and wait and pick me up. So I got there and waited just a little bit, and he kept his word and picked me up and brought me up to my hotel. So it was really cool. So the motel is really cheap. It's $55 a night. Super hiker friendly to me. So the guy was very accommodating. He did all of our laundry for us, no charge. There was a few other hikers that came in after me. So when they got here, he kind of pulled all of our laundry together and then did it himself. And anyway, but he was just really nice and very accommodating of hikers. So. The motel room looks like a place straight out of the 70s. So it is, pretty much green all the way around. Flowers in the bathroom. A lot of gnarly colors here of tile. But it was super clean. My room was at least. They just had cleaned it. You could smell the bleach in the bathroom. And I was happy with this place. So for $55, I couldn't complain. There's no Wi-Fi here, unfortunately, so I couldn't upload any videos. But it was exactly what I needed. I slept really well last night. So today we're going to cross over the Hudson River, which is going to be really cool. There's a beach over there. So I'm probably 22-ish miles away from there. So it will be Sunday night, early evening when I get there. It's about 10 o'clock. I'm gonna try to get back on the trail. There's no hitchhiking in New York, so I don't know how I'm gonna get there yet, but there's a gas station just down the road, Valero. It's the only place really around this area. And I know they have some breakfast food down there, and then see if I can catch a ride up there. So, and we'll see what happens. All right, guys, well, I'll see you on the trail. All right, everyone, so we are just crossed Interstate, actually it's not interstate, I think it's County Road 17. Very busy four lane highway, it's probably Highway 17. And I wanted to kind of give you a recap of what the first 20-ish miles are in New York. So I expected to come into New York. I heard from some folks that there are people doing 30s up in New York. So I'm like, man, I can't wait to get to New York. Sounds like it's gonna be easy. The first 20 miles so far in New York is very comparable to the roller coaster you go through in Virginia, except it's steeper and rockier. So it hasn't been easy at all. Luckily, in most of the gaps so far, there are people that have like 20 to 25 bottles of water. Not bottles, gallon jugs of water for all the hikers, because the water is just so dry here in New York right now. So, New York is kicking my butt so far. Not used to, after going through Pennsylvania, New Jersey, we were riding ridges a lot of the time. You know, New York is completely the opposite. Like immediately when you cross in New York, it's like that. So, but anyway, for advice for you through hikers going northbound, make sure you have a lot of water and don't underestimate New York, at least not the beginning. We'll see what it looks like. It looks like it gets a little bit easier as you get closer to Bear Mountain. Bear Mountain is, I think, the closest area towards Manhattan, so it's probably going to be very touristy
So the grade of the AT is probably gonna be really favorable. So that'll be nice, but we'll see what happens. We got another 700-foot climb coming up here, and kind of looks decently steep. So, all right, and we're crossing over Interstate. I can't remember what interstate this is now, but when we get to Bear Mountain, when you look out in the observation tower, I guess you can see the New York City skyline from Manhattan, which is pretty cool. So, all right, guys, check back.
The lemon squeezer. It's a good thing I lost 35 pounds.
All right, so it's 4 o'clock here, afternoon of day 65, and decided to stop down at Tiarati Beach, Tiarati Lake actually. There's a beach there. It's right off of Hardin Road, mile marker 1388 and some change. And the beach is free. It's got free showers. And then there was 3 vending machines down there. Soda machine, candy machine, and then an ice cream machine. And I definitely spent my lunch money at the ice cream machine. So, but I packed out some pizza from last night. I had a couple of big pieces left and had that for lunch, with a nice soda and a bunch of ice cream, so I feel really good. I was hiking the last 5 or 6 miles with a guy named Chili Dog. He started back on the 6th or 7th of April, and he was doing 30s through a big part of Virginia with a guy named Spoon, and he got sick, and his hiking buddy ended up leaving him, and he's been just doing 20s, but he had a really fast pace. I had a hard time keeping up with him for a little bit. So, but it was kind of fun hiking with someone with that kind of a pace. He's getting off trail for 4 or 5 days for the 4th. He lives in Connecticut. So a lot of the hikers that I've been running into lately, a lot of them are getting off the trail for 4 to 7 days to take a break and spend time with their friends and family on 4th of July. Most of them live in this area, so it's really convenient for them. Hit a big bubble of hikers today. So the shelter that was a couple miles before West Mombasa, where I got back on the trail today, there was like 25 hikers there last night, which is the most I've heard in a long time. So I caught up with a lot of those at one of the gaps today. So kind of cool seeing a bunch of hikers again. It's been hot and humid today. Luckily there's been a lot of trail magic in the way of jugs of water at many of the gaps. And then at the Tiarati Lake, there is a water spigot there so you can fill up your water. The place was hopping though. It's a Sunday today, and there was probably maybe 200 people at the little picnic area, maybe 50 or 60 at the beach, maybe more. But definitely the place to be, especially on a hot day like today. So I'm about 12 miles or so from crossing over the Hudson River. I wanted to get past there today. The only downside is I'm not going to be able to hike through the zoo. There's a zoo that you go through right before you cross the Hudson, and the AT literally goes through it for about 1/4 mile. And the bear cage is officially the lowest point of elevation on the entire Appalachian Trail. It's 100 and something feet. The zoo is only open 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. So even if I decided to hold up before that. I would probably have to wait around to hope for it to open up tomorrow, and I'm not going to do that. So we'll see what happens. All right, so we are just off, actually we're in the middle of Palisades Parkway, busy four-lane highway that will take you right into New York City. 34 miles east is NYC. If you walk 0.4 miles, you're gonna come to Visitor Center, just up here. The reason why I'm walking up here is because it has water. It is so dry in New York City right now, or New York. You can see the grass here. Most of all the springs and creeks and rivers are dried up, so I haven't hit any water since I left the beach, and I'm not risking it. There's water probably 6 or 7 miles from here when I get close to the Hudson, but for how hot and humid it's been out, I only have a half a liter of water left, and it's just not going to make it. So I'm gonna fuel up here. It's almost a mile out of my way between going here and back, but you gotta do what you gotta do. All right, so no restrooms here. There's a shop here that is open 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. It's after 5, but this is our only safe haven. So, nice. Would like to go to the bathroom, but oh well. There is some trash cans here, just over here, but got what I wanted here. Now we gotta walk 0.4 miles back. It felt like it was more than 0.4 miles. It felt like a half mile. But, all right, well, we'll be in Bear Mountain in a couple hours. We're about 6 miles. So, it should be, I'm assuming that the trail is gonna get pretty manageable, because of all, we're so close to New York City and there's so many day hikers, so usually it's pretty well groomed. So, in AWOL's guide though, it does say, watch for the white blazes the next 3 miles coming out of the Palisades. So, I don't know. I don't know what to expect. But I passed three more hikers that are staying. I mentioned the shelter that you can see the skyline from. It's actually called West Mountain. I said, something Brian, that was the one that was far a couple of shelters back. So it's West Mountain, and God, there's I'd probably pass 10 or 15 people a day that are gonna stay there, so that will be packed. But I'm sure it'll be nice to have a view of the skyline without having to deal with all the day hikers and visitors like you'll see at Bear Mountain. That we'll see here in a little bit. All right, well, back on the trail. All
right, so this is one of the creeks going up to a West Mountain shelter. This is exactly what most of the water sources have looked like. So
the stream right before this actually has some water in it, and it's barely flowing. I wouldn't be surprised in another week if it was completely dry, if they don't get any rain. Most of the water was stagnant, so I'm kind of glad I made the choice that I did and just walked down the Palisades. By the time you get the water out and filter it for all the water, I probably only ended up wasting 5 minutes, if even that, since I didn't have to filter water, it comes right out of the spigot. So I would definitely recommend going down the Palisades, and unless if you have a ton of water and you can make it. So, all right, well, we're going to head up West Mountain. The last few climbs have not been bad at all. This climb, however, looks like it's steep on gut hooks. Yeah, so, but there's gonna be a lot of views getting up to the top of this, actually this, and then after this mountain is Bear Mountain, so I'm gonna have a lot of cool views as we get close to sunset. We actually still a few hours from sunset. I think it's like 6:15 or 6:30. So, all right. Hey guys, so we're on top of Bear Mountain. It's just about sunset, and I just had some trail magic. the vending machine actually gave me trail magic. So I paid for a Powerade. It gave me two. Shh, don't tell anybody. I don't want to, I don't want to get caught. But isn't that great? Trail magic from something that's non-human. Hey, good morning, everyone. Today is day 66. It is the, I think it's the 27th of June. It's Monday, I know that. So I ended up hiking till about 11 o'clock last night, 10:30 maybe. And I was gonna go to a campsite that is just a couple miles out of the climb after you cross the Hudson, but as I kind of expected, it was completely full. So I camped about a quarter mile down the road on a random flat spot. I was on a patch of rocks. It took me forever to pitch my tent. I don't think I went to bed till about 12:30. So it was a late night, long day. I didn't get started yesterday until about 10:45. So I only hiked about 12 hours, but ended up getting, I think it ended up working out to about 28.3-ish miles. The only crummy part was, because I was hiking so late, I didn't get a chance to go through the zoo, which I knew was gonna happen. And it was really dark going over the Hudson, so the views weren't the best. It's beautiful out today. I got on the trail at 8:15 this morning, and I'm sure the water situation is going to be exactly like it was yesterday, so I'm going to stop by this baseball field that is taken care of by this Spiritual Life Center, and have been allowing hikers to fill up water, use restrooms, and camp in their field for last 40 something years. So that's what my plan is. It's only 2.5 miles from where I camped last night. Got about a half liter of water, so I have enough to get to there. It's a 0.4 mile blue blaze, but it's on a paved road, so that will be nice. The mile marker last night I stayed at was 1406.6, I think. So maybe it was a little bit under that, 1405.6. That's probably what it was actually. So I was looking at kind of where to stay and would like to get 30 miles in today. So there is a shelter at mile marker 1438. So depending on how I feel will determine whether or not I want to go with a few extra miles. But want to be in Great Barrington, which is mile marker 1520 by Thursday. So I got to average about 28 and a half or so miles the next 4 days. Totally doable. I think we're through with the harder part of New York. First 25 miles in New York were tough. Hey everyone. We're about 3 miles in, 4 miles in the day. And you cross US 9, there is a Shell gas station right there at the corner of the intersection. And I missed that on AWOL's guide. So I was able to, they have a full deli. I was able to grab a sandwich, fill up all my water, some Powerade. And then I ate some yogurt, fruit, and a couple other things. So felt really good. When I was filling up my water outside, they had a 16-year-old kid that was watering the grass, and which I don't really know why they're watering the grass. It's all dead, and it's so hot out that it's probably not going to do anything, but the kid just falls over. You know, it's like 9:30 in the morning. It's not super hot yet, but he fell over. I thought he tripped, but he didn't get back up. So I ran over there and he's passed out. So had one of the hikers go and notify the staff, and he came to a few seconds later, so we had him just sit up and gave him some Powerade, and luckily there was someone there that had some medical experience and was able to help. But that was kind of freaky there for a second. So, but they're calling his dad and they're gonna get him to the doctor, so he's in good hands. There's a state park about 14 miles from here. I'm hoping I can get there without having to resupply my water. I got 2.5 liters, and it doesn't seem as hot as it was yesterday. So I think it's feasible. There's also a beach there. We've been running into lots of beaches lately, and a concession, so. But that is for sure guaranteed water. There is one other place, I think between here and there, that you have to walk maybe 4/10 off the trail to get some water. I think it's 7 miles up from here. So if this is not enough, I have that option, but I think I'll be fine. But I'll tell you, New York is kind of a different monster. It's just so dry. I don't know that I've filtered water once because there's nothing to filter. One of the hikers told me that he was told once you cross the state line, all the way to Barrett Mountain is the toughest section of New York, and I believe it. It's probably one of the tougher sections that we've seen on the trail, just with all of the climbs and how steep they were and how close together they were. Some of the other hikers were saying that was the toughest part of the trail. I don't know if it's the toughest part, but if it's definitely the toughest we've had in a while, so. All right, well, we'll see kind of how things go. I'm excited I don't have to walk 8/10 of a mile to get water here at the Spiritual Life Center now that I'm all filled up. So the time that I took eating and all that stuff probably just balances out what it would have taken me to walk down there. But I'd rather be eating and spend a few bucks than walk a mile out of my way for warm water. So, all right, well, I will catch you, catch everyone just on the trail. See what happens next. Hey guys, so we're here at Clarence State Park and it's finally raining. We haven't gotten rain in like weeks. Be good for how dry it's been out here. But got Bullet here. So I just met Bullet. This guy is freaking insane. He started, no problem. He started May 10th, right? May 10th. So I hiked with him for the first half of the day. We're gonna hike together today and then tomorrow and then do the Connecticut 50 mile state challenge on Wednesday. So it's gonna be crazy. And then I've been hearing a lot about this guy from tons of people, Spielberg. And I finally ran into this son of a gun right here. What's this up? Spielberg. Hey, so we've been spending, hours just complaining about how hard some of this shit is sometimes, but how much fun we have with creating these videos and best bets and all that kind of crap. So yeah, it's been kind of fun just to run into someone else that's doing this. He's got a really popular YouTube channel as well. What's the name of yours again? Craig's AT Through Hike. And he was showing some of his videos. I haven't seen it. The videos are awesome. And check them out. You'll love them. So I'll get you a few more subscribers too.
Thanks, Nick.
But no, they're really awesome stuff. And you have what iPhone do you have? The
6S? 6S Plus, yeah.
6S Plus, man. Oh my God. So much better than the 6 that I have. The video footage is amazing. So, yeah, again, check it out. All right, well, we're going to head out, do 9 miles, and then tomorrow's going to be an easy 21-mile day, and we'll set us up for the Connecticut Challenge. So, should be fun. All right, well, I'll check you guys later. Hey, good morning, everyone. Today is day 67. It is Tuesday, the 28th of June. So we stayed at right behind a deli last night. Mile marker was 1433.5. And got there about 8:30. It was a pizza place and a deli. The deli closes at 8. So unfortunately we missed that, but we're able to get squeezed in an order for a large pizza right before they shut the doors. They're cool enough to accommodate us, even though I think they're actually closed at 8:30. So I spent most of the day yesterday. I think I did 29 miles yesterday, and 25 of those miles were with Bullet. And my gosh, that guy can fly. So as you heard at the state park, Bullet started on May 10th, which I just can't get over that. I know how hard it's been for me getting here in 66 days. And he started 17 days later than me. So this is like day 50 for him. It's absolutely insane. So when we hiked into Clarence State Park yesterday, we were probably averaging 3 miles an hour. And that's just a little bit faster than what my normal pace is, so it wasn't too bad keeping up with them. And we hung around the state park. It started raining, so we were gonna kind of just wait around to wait out the rain because it was only supposed to last for an hour and a half. Well, it never stopped. So when we left, I think it was like 5:30. And the place we wanted to stay at was 10 miles away. So we were averaging 3.5 miles an hour for that 10 miles. We got here in like 3 hours or just under. And man, I was just worn out. I just cannot believe the pace that this guy can go at. So it's his birthday today, actually. So he actually is waiting for a friend, and he's at the deli still. His friend's gonna come here and they're gonna hike together. And then he's going to get off the trail and stay at his place tonight. But we were talking about doing the Connecticut Challenge, which is hiking the entire state of Connecticut in one day, under a day. It's 50 miles. I've done a hike that long before, but I don't know that I can sustain his endurance. So our plan was for me to stay, I'm gonna stay at the Wiley shelter, which is a mile before the state line, and get up really early and start a challenge. So I haven't decided how early I want to get up. It's supposed to storm this afternoon, and just kind of thinking about how the day turns out. If it never storms and I get to the Wiley shelter at 2 o'clock, it's gonna be hard for me just to stop, so I might just keep on going. But we'll see what happens. But still, it's amazing, this kid. He hasn't lost any weight on the trail. He's just in incredible shape. He's a runner. And his target is to be done July 20th, which will be 72 days. It's crazy. All right, well, I'm getting back on the trail here, and it's cloudy out. I'm wet, but I'm not cold, so that's good. All right, guys, I'll check back later. All right, so it is 1:15, and the sun literally just started peeking out when I turned on this video, which is kind of crazy. Good timing. So we're probably about 13 miles in. Been moving faster than I expected. probably averaging about 3 mile an hour pace. So if I decide to just stay at the Wiley shelter is probably only about 8 or 9 miles from here. I'm gonna get there by like 4 o'clock or before. And I wouldn't know what to do with all the time. I've never gotten to a shelter on the AT, I think, before 6:30. So if the weather holds off, which it has been, it's supposed to storm 30%. It's not too many times that I can recall when there's been a 30% chance that it actually has stormed. But if it stays like this, I'm probably just gonna go into Connecticut and hike till 7, go to bed early, and then finish the rest of Connecticut tomorrow, do like a 40-something mile day, which is probably better for my body than trying to push and do 52 mile day and do all Connecticut, especially with Bullet. I just don't know if I can keep up with them for the entire state. So if I have a little bit of a lead, it'll be better for me to be able to sustain and knock out the rest of the state. So, but that would set me up for a 50 mile day on Thursday. So if I can only have a 15 mile day to get into Great Barrington, I should be able to get there, depending on what time I get on the trail, but man, I should be able to get there by 1-2 at latest, and really enjoy a good amount of the day in Great Barrington. I heard that there is a beach right by the hotel I'm staying at the Day's Inn, so I could even go up over there. But anyway, those are just things that are thoughts that are going through my head. Feel good. Hasn't been a lot of water. I did find two water sources today, so I definitely filled up when I had the opportunity. But even with the rain last night, most of the streams that I've been walking by are still dry. So they're moist at best. But we are walking through some farmlands here in New York. It's kind of cool. We just went through a pasture, and then after this climb up here, we're going through another set of pastures. So should be a nice little change. All right, well, I'll update when I get to Wiley Shelter, see what the weather conditions are and what I decide to do. Until then.
Hey, good evening, everyone. It's evening of day 67, and we are at the Wiley Shelter. It is a mile before the border of Connecticut, and I decided I am gonna do the Connecticut Challenge, 52 miles. And my plan is to get up around 2 a.m., be on the trail no later than 2:30. If it's raining, 2:45, 3 o'clock at absolute latest. I would like to be finished as it gets dusk. I figured it would take me probably about 18, maybe 19 hours to do this. So the earlier I get up, the better. It's just quarter after 7 p.m. I'm going to bed right now. Today was an easy day. The last 20 miles of New York are very easy, so it's been pleasant. I got to the shelter here about quarter after 4, earliest that I've ever been into a shelter. It was really weird, to be honest. I didn't know what to do with all my time, but I got everything ready for tomorrow. It shouldn't take longer than 20 minutes. We need to get everything together. If it's raining, I add 10 minutes to that. But Bullet is going to be doing the 52-mile challenge as well, the Connecticut challenge. I don't think he's going to start till 4, but he's going to hike a little bit faster than me. So I'm sure I'll see him tomorrow. There's a campsite maybe 2 or 3 tenths of a mile after the border once we get into Mass. So I should be able to find a spot right away, and again, if it's before dusk, then it will be a little bit easier. That will put me at about a 15-mile day to get into Great Barrington on Thursday. So, but fill up my belly tonight for dinner. I pumped enough water so that I don't have to worry about water tomorrow morning. So I am all ready to go. So we'll see how it goes. Stay tuned. And I'm excited. So this is, you know, the only challenge I'm really doing. So, but it worked out with the mileage, and I think that my body can totally handle it. I've done 50-ish miles before. So, all right, well, I'll see you guys in the morning. Big fuck.